This cut ends here, year after year after year. I don't know if it's an actual deep water channel or whether this is from fishermen. Almost ran into a beaver dead ahead, probably 6 or 7 years ago at this point. Maybe less. Ooh, it's beautiful out. Almost can't stand it. I see kayakers or it's never going to look that straight with the heel of the boat. It's going to be looking up to the sky. It's not too bad. fish. Deer. It should be a camera dead ahead right now. Let's see if I can do a zoomy zoom. Browsing the shoreline. Where are they? There they are. Oh, a canoe. Branta canadensis or canadiensis? God, that tree makes it look like I'm paddling the Okavango. At least one of those geese will stay there and tuck its head down and hope against hope that I don't notice it. Right now we're in the molt. Geese can't fly. Won't be able to fly for a couple months. They can like surface skim the water, but they can't do that sentinel's waving his head at me. That's a warning behavior. It's a warning signal. That's the one watching out for all the other geese, the sentinel. But it's all muck back here. There's a little bay if you go around. What's that? spook him. I'm not gonna bother you, bird. Oh, that one I am. Okay, I guess both of you guys. Sorry. Destined to be struggling with some weeds regardless of which way I go. Ooh! Largemouth. Whoa! Big largemouth! Why would I bring my paddling stuff? Oof. Pop over the leaves. Big island. And go to the smaller island. Rachel Mini Orectorini Pandini. Massaged me. apologize if it looks like I'm wandering. I'm just dodging submergent vegetation. Interferes with my paddling. There's a muskrat, just dove. Base position. Doubt that showed up on the board. Can't all be winners. Might have been my mom's motto when she conceived me. No, Alexa Price is the best one to me. Alright, whoever messages me while I'm out on this paddling trip gets a link to the YouTube video. I better get a micro SD card. Rachel, Alex, if I can't have paddling spots like this in Oregon, then it's a no-go. But I imagine somewhere between the ocean and the mountains, there's lakes. It's just that I know that canoeing's never really taken off in the Pacific Northwest. I mean, there's a lot of whitewater and sea kayaking, so maybe it's too boring for a lot of people. Or some of the people. Man, there's so much stimuli. Here's the island. Some jackalope has built a teepee in the middle of it, which is not appropriate really for a state park. Jackalope. 5. Another birdie. Looking to get some of those bluegills. Good for you, bird. Not totally stable on edge in this canoe yet, but it's a 16-foot solo with a 28 or 29-inch max width, so the only way to turn it effectively, quickly, is on edge. And Alexa Price, if you watch this, I don't know if red kayaks turn better when they're on edge, but having a double-bladed paddle works. I paddle 99% on one side with corrective strokes. But man, sometimes it's just so damn nice in a kayak. Covered decks, the wind slips right over you. Butte. Up there. Should be straight soon. Molting and goslings, that time of year. All right, Rachel, you ready to hear how quiet a canoe is? Underwater recoveries, palm roll, he's talking about. I'm paddling right now. Oops. Maybe I can get a video of that. I never know. That might do it. Shot up the gork. We won't know. We won't terribly care. We'll lean a little bit. guys know what I never see here? Bald eagles. You'd think there'd be a ton. They're all over Maple River. There's less people, though. This is just so goddamn jam-packed full of fish. And Rachel, you want to know something else about canoes? Alex, I feel like you're less interested in this stuff. But you too. When you're in a canoe, your paddle is vertical to the water. And you don't get drippies coming in the kayak. Drippies running down the paddle shaft in the kayak. Tempted to go grab some of those type of shoots. If I can find a better patch, I'm gonna eat some. I'm going to need some shoes. Mm-hmm. Still with one hand here. Bow press. I pushed off the bottom. It's cheating. Oh, I could do this. Wow, this thing is really on there. This is a little bit terrifying of a prospect. That could be cool. Little gauzes on the sewer. All right, fine, I won't go in there. Don't put too much pressure on the geese if you, there's too many of you guys. Oh my God. There's a lot of taipa over by the dam, and I'm gonna head in there and I'm gonna pull some shoots and eat them. Loaded in potassium. Way more than a banana. All the back cramps I've been having. gaggle of kayakers over there. I wish I'd caught that on camera. A heron had flanked me and almost like he like on the tangent of its curve near me, he let out a big old dump. Kayakers are playing really loud music, that's all right. Oh, I see, that's where everybody is, at the beach. I guess that makes sense. Point there, I get out of the weeds. Still not as many people as I thought there would be. I'm not feeling any need to get too close to that, so thank you. It's a pleasant sound. I hope it's a dog. Or if it's not a dog, somebody named their kid Fabio. Romeo. Oh, there's multiple. One of them might be named Romeo, and the other one Fabio. So that's sweet. I bet their house is so ornate. Corinthian pillars, lots of light tones, gold accents. There's a doggy in the water over there. It's a black lab. That could be Corey Higley or something. When you get closer, the noise isn't quite as enjoyable. I like it in the distance. The water here is clean and nice to swim in. Hardly fault them. That's a good dog. What happens in the water? Gotta love a lab. Thank you.